This is the main gate of Mdina. As you can see, it is a Baroque gate with elaborate stone carvings. Actually, Maltese stone is a limestone that is lends itself very well for carving. In fact, when you go to places like Mdina, it's good to look at the balconies because they have some nicely intricate carvings. I'm no historian, of course, so don't be impressed. But Mdina is interesting because it is a Baroque town with Baroque palaces and doorways, but sitting on the footprint of an Arab Medina, because that is what it was. Over the years, in the Baroque period, they made it a bit larger. They introduced more Baroque buildings, of course, and so some characteristics of an Arab Medina were lost. It is a fortress city. In fact, you will see it is surrounded by walls, and inside you can see many stately homes. I'm drinking Kini, by the way. This is maybe the traditional Maltese soft drink. It is a non-alcoholic drink. It has been produced since 1952, actually, and the recipe is held secret by the family of the owners of the factory. But they say that it is bitter oranges and there's ginseng and rhubarb inside. Actually, it's a drink that I find out that foreigners either like it or hate it. So it's difficult to hate a drink, I know, but that's the reactions you have. For me, the favorite would be if it is served chilled, of course, on some ice and a slice of orange. And then it is a very good companion to any food, practically, especially in such hot weather like this. It's May and you can see what kind of weather we have. It's good for a suntan before the summer, you know? Cheers. I needed that.